My name is Lisa Damore, and I'm a playwright in residence here at the McDowell Colony, and we're here in the Garland Studio where I live and work. I'm working on several projects right now. One is a play called Airline Highway, which is set in New Orleans, which is where I grew up. And this is a play that involves a cast of about 9 characters who all live in the same hotel on the outskirts of New Orleans. Many of them work in the French Quarter, and it all takes place over the course of one day. And on that day, they are preparing to throw a funeral for one of their friends who has not yet died. Her name is Miss Ruby. She's 85 years old, and she's been a burlesque dancer on Bourbon Street for 45 years. And Miss Ruby has requested a funeral before she passes away so that she can hear all of the good things that people have to say about her. In about a month, we'll do a 2-week workshop of the play with actors and a director. And that will be an opportunity for me to work more on the script and also for them to decide if they're going to produce it. The other project that I'm working on is a play called Cherokee, which is about 2 couples from Houston who go camping in Cherokee, North Carolina, which is a Native American reservation at the foot of the Smoky Mountains. I find it a place that is rich in history and also rich in capitalist enterprise. It's a really fascinating place. So these 2 couples from Houston, one who's Caucasian, one who's African American, they've been friends for a while. They decide to go on a vacation to Cherokee soon after one of the men is laid off from his job. Very soon into the play, the African-American man is either abducted or runs away. So you're left with these 3 people, and they're befriended by a young Native American man as they try to find this 4th member of their party or decide maybe they'll just stay and live in Cherokee. So it's a play that really explores people who are interested in getting back to nature, in getting back to living off the land, who are maybe considering giving up the life and line of work they feel they've been born into. And a lot of strange and wonderful things happen. All of my plays, almost always, they're very rooted in a specific place. So whether the play is set in 2 backyards and the backyards radically transform by the end of the play, or whether it is set in this crumbling hotel that is a safe haven for all of these almost underworld outsider characters. The location is always a very vivid part of the dramatic action. I went to college in the South, but then I left for many years. And I often say that I basically spent about 15 years being homesick, just trying to get back to the South. And now I do live back there, and it's a huge relief. So I think maybe there's like the pull of places that I've missed that might really make me consider the emotional impact of a place or a location or a setting in a piece of theater.